welcome those that are watching this discourse on live feed. And I also want to welcome those that will be watching this discourse on live feed after it has been posted in the various groups around the world. You can bribe the water how much you want. The water can bring you whisky in the cellar, cigarettes in the cellar, Kentucky in the cellar, and Nandos in the cellar. As long as you are in prison, you have not achieved. So Vaishnavite Gurus, descend on this earth timeously on behalf of the Supreme Personality of Godhead to salvage the souls that are submerged. And in amnesia. So generally, the public thinks when gurus give this type of discourses that the gurus are insane. The public thinks when gurus give this type of discourses, then the guru should be rushed to a psychiatric ward for treatment. Okay? This is the general view of the populace that's going to be listening to a type of discourse like this. They'll say, this guru is insane. How am I suffering from amnesia? I know my name. I am Radharani Ramanuj Dasi. I am married to Narshima Ramanuj Dasi. How can I be suffering from amnesia? My husband is a singer in a bhajan group. He sings so well. He writes poems and poetry on God. How can we be suffering from amnesia? There is only one amnesia that we are suffering from, which is continuous since time immemorial. And that is, we believe, that we are this body. We believe that we are this body. So today I'm going to tell you who you really are. Lodged inside, seated on your left hand side, on the position where your biological heart is an atomic point of light called the soul. An atomic point of light called the soul. This soul has two types of consciousness, substantive consciousness and attributive consciousness. The substantive consciousness of the soul will make you aware of yourself, and the attributive consciousness is projected outside. It is a symptom of the soul. How many of you understand what consciousness is? It is that which animates this body. This outer body that you all are looking at now, this body on its own has no life. If you chop off this hand, and when this hand falls on the floor, this hand won't have any life because it is disconnected from the consciousness which animates it. You have heard of people that had their hands amputated. You have heard and saw and witnessed the life take place in the amputated part. No, it cannot. So it is the consciousness that animates and gives the appearance of life to the outer covering which we call the body. Inside this body, there is another body called the astral body, or the subtle body. All illnesses occurs in the subtle or astral body, and it manifests itself on the gross body. This gross body that we are wearing today is to experience pleasures and pains that we computed in our previous lifetime as a human. So whatever we are going through in this lifetime, today, whatever we went through yesterday, whatever we went through from birth, it is that which we attained and computed in our previous life. And that cycle goes on and on and on until you meet your guru. When you meet a guru, when you submit to the teachings that the guru expounds in total surrender, then that cycle breaks. That karmic cycle breaks and you are no longer impelled by karma of your previous lifetime. You are now impelled by divinity because you have now become divine. Your sentence is over. So your guru is like a parole officer. He walks into the prison, and if you conform to the regulative principles as set out by the guru, then the guru removes you from this prison at the end of this lifetime. But the guru also brings you from the lower levels where you are getting tortured in life, he brings you to a section of the prison where in the prison you will have fulfillment and a taste for what is in the outside life. This has already been proven since time immemorial. So when these material universes are created, Lord Narayan goes and sleeps on the causal ocean or the Virajagara. From his navel, which scientists call the black hole, have you heard of scientists calling or talking about the black hole And they are also talking about the Big Bang. So they're getting close to the Vedic injunctions, and one day when they decide to work with the Gurus, then we will show them exactly how this universe is created. Right now, they want to work in the ascending process. Ascending process means experiment, learn from the experiment, discard that is not necessary, and experiment again. If the experiment works according to data that is already here, then it was successful. And if that experiment works contrary to data that is here already, then that experiment is unsuccessful. That is the scientific mind. But we invite all the scientists to keep a guru in their camp, because the guru sees things as they really are. The gurus sees things as they really are. So let us examine creation from the navel of Lord Narayan. So in your lifetime, you would have heard that from the navel of Lord Narayan grows a lotus stem. Some of you heard that somewhere in your lifetime. And on top of that lotus stem, Lord Brahma is born. Somewhere you would have learned. Okay? And it is Lord Brahma who is the secondary creator of the universe, all the ingredients provided by Lord Narayan. So when Lord Brahma created the very first living entity that were born from his mind, were the four Kumaras. Four Kumaras, very first entity that were born from the mind of Lord Brahma, were the four Kumaras, and these Kumaras represent the Guru Principle. These Kumaras represent the Guru Principle. So before anything else was born in this material universe, the Guru Principle took its birth first. Lord Brahma was upset when he asked them to procreate. They said they're not going to procreate, they're going to worship the Supreme Personality of Godhead and expound his teachings. And that is called the Guru Principle. So in this material universe, the very first birth after Lord Brahma was the Guru Principle. In Lord Brahma's anger was born Lord Shiva. In Lord Brahma's anger, from in between his eyebrows, was born Lord Shiva. So the Guru Principles together with Lord Shiva. And the expounder, I stated at the last Satsang of the Guru Gita, is Lord Shiva to Mother Parvati. So this is how important the Guru Principle is. This is how important Lord Shiva is. And whoever attains a Guru, you attain that Guru through the grace of Lord Shiva only. It is Lord Shiva that connects you to a Guru. However, you do not have capacity to seek a Guru. So wherever you are, the Guru finds you. And we have proven this scientifically as well, 2 weeks ago, I found a devotee of mine in America, those of you that will follow my Facebook post, and we're keeping this live and tangible and current to show the world that the Vedas are absolute. The Vedas are absolute. It's existing today as it existed during the Vedic period, and the relevance is today as it was then. So we have from America, and one day before meeting me, she asked God to meet a master. And the next day, she met me to one of these discourses that was posted in a group in America. And she contacted, and she has surrendered, and she has become a disciple. How many thousand kilometers away? So this fact that the Guru finds you has evidenced itself in our satsang. She is not the only one. We have devotees, other devotees from America, South America, Nepal in India, that are finding their Guru, although there are thousands of Gurus in India. Can you count how many Gurus there are in India? You understand? Even just before I jumped out of the car to come into this satsang, I had a video call from one of the ashrams in India. So I'm teaching you, and whatever I'm teaching you is absolute. Absolute means that the result is genuine. It is your faith that will make your relationship or your understanding with what I am stating successful or not. So if you come with the attitude, "Yeah, let's wait and see," then the Guru will wait and see. If you come with the attitude that the Guru, although I do not understand spirituality, but I believe whatever the Guru is saying to be absolute, then in a few weeks' time, all your material woes will be solved. You mustn't. You just turn back to the pride that's living. Yeah, okay, you can turn back again. This pride introduced himself, Mr. Chairman, to me when he met me in the past. He said he is one of the very old members of this institution. You can hardly see now, and he stated you cannot even hear from him. And he said he remembers the days when him and his wife walked around standing looking for relationships. So, again, he had the opportunity to come and sit in our satsang today. And we ourselves are honored to find somebody from the founding days to be here. Okay. And they are great people all around the world, whom we sometimes forget in the work that is put in so that we can be happy. When I was in Sri Lanka in September, I went to a Ganesha temple, and I think there was about 800 stairs carved into rock. And I teared on my way up. Every time I stood on the stair, I felt the presence of those people 3,000 years ago that must have taken a chisel and hammer and carved that stairway over years. It couldn't have happened in one person's lifetime. This temple is right on the top of a mountain. And I cried on my way up, had it not been for these people, look at how selfless they were, so that the Guru can come back to South Africa and in December 2018 give a discourse on what they did selflessly 3,000 years ago. Can you understand? Every step that I took, I felt my conscience starting. Those rocks are as hard as granite. If the stairway is still there, with the carvings on the stairway itself, it was a lot of work. And this is our Sanatan Dharma. This is our Sanatan Dharma. They know who Lord Ganesha is. They know who Lord Shiva is. They know who Lord Narayan is. All these temples in South India, if you go, spend at least 25% of your time, visit one temple that is 3,000 or 4,000 years. Go see the hard work that was done. Today we got excavators and chains. We can take statues and place them wherever we want. Those days they didn't have the luxury of machinery and equipment. What was that drive and that push behind them to construct these temples in India? Thousands and thousands of years ago. Why would they leave everything in life and construct temples? So, it is not necessary to change your religion. It is not necessary to change anything in your culture. We have the most vibrating culture, Mr. Chairman. Whatever you want to be found culturally is found in Sanatana. But we need clear knowledge to reach our children, because our children are confused, and in their confusion they are looking for an easy way out, because in the year 2018 everything is about the easy way out. When we first started coming to this temple, we did not ask for your life and ask you directions. Right, you have said take the first line, second line, third line, fifth line until you land at the temple. We took the easy way out. We just put the address, GPS, and a lady told us, make fry. In 500 meters, turn left. Okay, so we are taking the easy way out. The normal way we were used to, the hard way, is phone, not from your car. You needed to have a few coins ready. First, find a call box. Then phone high. And then you would write and even draw the directions. Okay? Now our children don't need to go. Wherever they are, you can phone. Wherever you are, you can phone, and I'm sure the phones are visiting bathrooms and toilets as well. Okay? So, easy way out. This is the culture of 2018. Easy way out. Some of them want to find God through their cell phone. Yes, you can type in there, Lord Narayan. All the information of Lord Narayan is there. Type in Lord Shiva. All the information of Lord Shiva is. But be very careful. Because the Western world has distorted a whole lot of Vedic injunctions that prevailed in India when they invaded India. And also, when India was invaded by the Muslims, they changed a lot of things, and those changed things are being found on the internet. So the internet is not going to give you absolute. Remember, the source of civilization is where? India. And the Western world destroyed a whole lot of evidence because they wanted to be the source of civilization. So when you read interpretations of any of the Vedas, look for a guru first. And if the guru gave a commentary on the Vedas, then Because writing a script in your mind is man's biggest downfall. What if it doesn't happen? Why that person looked at me like that? What did he or she have in their mind? And as you're going off to see it, then your mind will tell you, you saw that look on that person's face, then you'll get it. All the time the person didn't even look at you, the person looked past you at one beautiful tree on either side. But look at how much of stress you gave yourself. How much of stress you gave yourself. So, take this stress part of you and leave it at the feet of the Guru. All the stress that you have, when you come in down here, leave the stress at the feet of the Guru and you just go and mind your own business. Mind your own. Don't worry who looked at you how. You heard the tone she spoke to me. Forget about that. After she spoke to you, she is gone. She is having a jolly good time. You suffering from that tone she spoke to you. Alright? Forget the outside world. Forget the outside world. Worry about the peace inside. And to get that peace inside, I'm training you because I only see you once a month. Every morning, go to your prayer place and make a commitment. Today, God, I will not harm anybody. And let nobody harm me. Whatever happens today, happens to your grace and will. I will not contest it. So if in the night your life got cut, don't be angry with God. Tomorrow morning somebody will come and put your lights again. Because God does not work on your time. God works on His time. 311 trillion, 40 billion years on earth is 1 second in vacuum. How long? 1 second in vacuum. So God is not taking long. In that 1 second, He'll fix you. But in whose time? His time. Okay? I am here to tell you that if you have this body, then God gave you this body so you can hear this message from me. Okay? So if you catch a bird outside and I give this discourse to the bird, will the bird understand it? From the 8.4 million species, only the human body can understand the discourse that I have. And God sends gurus down to tell those that listen to the guru, God loves you. God loves you. And when somebody loves you, what you must do in return? Yes, otherwise there'd be a divorce. Right? So that is why we are divorced from God. Because nobody taught us to love God. Our parents have taught us that God is a order supply. Om Namo Narayan, I want that promotion tonight. Om Namo Narayan, I want a boy day. Om Namo Narayan. Om Namo Shivaya. I want my children to pass school. And you see his daily love? Demand. I am teaching you now only to love. You think the Almighty who does not miss an ant? How many of you saw ants somewhere? Okay? If you find an ant anywhere, my tradition, slap it for 24 hours. How long? In a matchbox. But give it air. Next morning, open the box. You'll see one small white grain in the box that wasn't there. You find one small white grain that's in the box that wasn't there. If God does not miss an ant, look at how big you are, how God will do this. But don't demand. If God wants to give you 1 billion rand, and you say, God, give me 200 rand for my groceries, what will they do? He'll give you 200 men. And then you'll say, God, no. So leave it to God. Let Him be the decider on what is good for you or not good for you. So how many of you are promising from tomorrow morning? You're going to make a commitment. And just be good only for that one day. How many days? Every day. So that one day, and if somebody fights with you, refer them to God. Right? Give the husband a break. Give the husband a break. Because I want you to pray with your husband. I promise you, God, that today I will not nag my husband or boyfriend. God, today I will not nag my husband or boyfriend. Do it together. Do it together. I'll tackle the men in 2020. From 2020 I'll start tackling the men, Mr. Chairman. Now I'm tackling the ladies. All in a joke. Yes, yes. Yes, because I gave an example, right? See, I'm going back to Devon now. Alright? So I'll be sitting with Sarita. And if I want to press her mouth brakes. Alright? When I press the brakes there and stand here, where do you think the mouth will start?
Devon. Devon.
In Stang.
No, somewhere in Devon. Yes. Right? So we're starting with that good speech thing. Because a woman generally, when she's going to sleep, she's fast asleep, eyes closed, but about 20 more sentences come out, alright? And before she opens her eyes, say, take out the food packet today, Tuesday. I still rubbing, get up, do this, alright? The man will just say, tell you this is a banana. A woman will tell you all the other fruits that a banana is not. You understand? And that is the good thing. That's where all the nonsense are. Okay, let's leave. Let the other go on, take over. Narayan. Take over.